Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Best of PowerPoint, and today I'll be talking about a very useful feature of PowerPoint known as hyperlinks. I will be explaining some very interesting things which you can do using this feature, so please do watch this video till the end. So what are hyperlinks? You must have observed a number of times that while surfing over the internet, there are some highlighted words, and when you click on them, you are always taken to some other web page. So it is basically a link to some other document, file, or a web page. This amazing feature is available in PowerPoint itself, and there are four things which you can do by using this feature. You can insert a hyperlink to a web page, to an existing file, to another slide in the presentation, and to an email address. Let's discuss all these one by one. First of all, let's talk about creating a hyperlink to a web page over the internet. Write the text on which you want your link to be placed. You can also place your link on an image or any other object. Then right-click the text and select hyperlink, and a new window appears. To create a hyperlink to a web page, what you need to do is just copy the URL of the web page and paste it on the address bar of this window. Like, I am going to paste the URL of one of my videos in this address bar. You can see that the color of the text has been changed and it has also been underlined. This means that our text is now hyperlinked to some other web page. You can also change the color of this hyperlinked text, and I will be explaining that in my next video. So when you press the F5 button and start the slideshow, just move your cursor on this highlighted text and click on this text, and you will see that you will be directed towards that particular web page. So this can be very useful to you when you need to switch to some other web page during your slideshow, and you don't need to switch to the browser separately. Just click on the link and you will be automatically directed to that web page from within the slideshow. However, you need to take care that you must have an active internet connection in order to view the web page. The second thing which you can link is a local file on your computer. Again, right-click on the text or any other object and select hyperlink. This time, browse for your desired file on your local system which you want to be linked, and then click OK. So again, when you click on it during the slideshow, your file will automatically get opened. So the main benefit is that you don't need to minimize your PowerPoint software while presenting the slideshow. It saves your time. Just click on the link and you will be directed towards that file or a web page. You don't need an active internet connection to link a local file, but you must take care that the file should be located on your system on which you are going to present the slideshow. Otherwise, if your file is not present on the system, then obviously PowerPoint will not be able to open that file. Third thing which you can do is link another slide using this hyperlink feature. This is also very useful. Let me just show this to you. For example, I have this flowchart with me in which I have written 5 separate topics, and I have made 5 individual slides in which I have explained these topics in detail separately. Now I want that when I click on this first topic, I should be automatically directed towards the detailed slide, and when I click on the second topic, I should be directed towards the detailed slide of that second topic, and so on. So again, following the same process, open the hyperlink settings window and this time choose the second option named place in this document. Here you have got all the options that which slide you want your text to be hyperlinked. Select that slide, and you can see that when I click on the text in this flowchart, I am automatically directed towards that detailed slide. However, what if you want to go back to the main slide again? For this, you can create a separate hyperlink in this detailed slide so that when you click on it, you are directed towards your main flowchart slide. And from here, you can again go to the second concept slide, and then third, and so on. The last thing which you can do here is that you can use the link to send an email. Just type the email address here. and when you click on the hyperlink, you will be shown the options to send the mail through the mail app, your browser, or through Outlook. However, this option is used in very rare cases, and the previously discussed options are more widely used than this one. Now let's talk about editing a hyperlink in your slide. Right-click the hyperlink text and choose Edit Link. Here you can edit the address of your webpage or local file, and you can also remove the link by clicking here. So this was all about the hyperlinks in PowerPoint, and in my next video, I will be explaining that how to change the colors of the hyperlink text. So please subscribe my channel to remain notified of my latest videos. So that's it guys, I hope that this video was helpful to you. Please like and share the video, and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and see you in my next video.